feel afraid, think I've lost my way. Still, you're there right beside me. Nothing will I fear as long as you are near. Please be near me to the end. Thy word is a lamp unto my feet and a light unto my path. Thy word is a lamp unto my feet and a light unto my path. I will not forget your love for me, and yet my heart forever is wandering. Jesus, be my guide and hold me by your side, and I will love you to the end. Nothing will I fear as long as you are near. Please be near me to the end.
If you know the song, sing with me.
Thy word is a lamp unto my feet and a light unto my path. Thy word is a lamp unto my feet and a light unto my path. You're the light unto
Good morning, and welcome to worship on this special day in the church year, a festival that we celebrate all saints, and we learn today who those saints are. They're not just those who are no longer with us, but we have a chance today to remember those who died within our congregation within this past year, remembering also those who were baptized this last year. And then we'll all get a chance to be invited to come forward to remember special ones that you still remember. That are part of your lives as well. So welcome to worship, those that are visiting with us and joining us on the line as well. We're glad that you're worshiping with us today. A few announcements before worship begins. Early this afternoon at 4 o'clock, the soup supper will be happening here, and we certainly invite you to come back to be a part of that. The funds raised for that will go to support the fuel cost needs that they have here at East Nidaros. So we hope it's a great time of food and good food and great time for fellowship as well, starting at 4 o'clock this afternoon. This may be subject to change. You'll hear it in the prayers today that Dale Thompson is in the hospital right now. It was planned that on the 19th, Dale would be and Judy would be celebrating their 60th anniversary after worship in Baltic. However, he may be getting some treatment for the next couple weeks, so we'll keep you updated as those plans develop. Next Sunday, we welcome the Hallelujah Hooligans to be part of our worship as well. We look forward to having them and sharing their music with us as we worship next Sunday. Then tomorrow evening will be Bible study at Baltic Lutheran at 6:30, and confirmation for the 8th graders at 6:30. 7th graders meet at 7:30. The food bank will be open this Wednesday, and then on Friday evening, 12 confirmation students from our 7th and 8th grade are going to be traveling to the Okoboji confirmation retreat camp, which we did last year, and they liked it so well that many of those that went last year are going again. So that's good news to hear that they're interested in doing that. So that'll be happening this weekend. And we appreciate your prayers as we travel and as they experience camp together. Birthdays this week: David Carl, Jess Schultz, Kyle Heggie, Sharon Singsaws, Kasten Rogers, Shavy Fiala, and Dylan Brandy. Birthdays this week. Happy birthday, Dylan. And anniversaries for Dick and Lori Berg and Travis and Christina Jervik. I believe those are the announcements that I have this morning. Are there any others from you? Yes, Nicole. Yes, please come up to the mic.
Good morning.
Good morning.
I would like to invite all of our church that's here and welcoming online to our Sunday school that's happening on November 19th. So not this next Sunday, but the Sunday after. And I think it's important for all generations to support our younger youth in Sunday school. And our lesson that we're going to be talking about is, who is the church? And so that's Sunday the 19th at 9:30 in the morning. So it's a little bit earlier. So we'll get the coffee on, get some fellowship going, and then invite you, like I said, to do a lesson with our Sunday school. Thank you.
Thank you, Nicole. Please keep that in mind. Are there any other announcements? Yes. Here.
I'm going to have surgery on Tuesday for my kidney stones and my drink size. I asked for
We will do that. Prayers for Harry this week as he has surgery on Tuesday. Thank you. Any others? If not, I invite you to stand as you are able as our worship begins, with a brief order of confession and forgiveness. Blessed be God, the one who forms us, Jesus, who bears the cross, and the Spirit who makes our joy complete. Amen. Let us bow before God in humility, confessing our sin. Steadfast and faithful God, you have revealed the ways of justice, yet we fail to follow you. We are overwhelmed by the world's violence and suffering. We are afraid to risk what we have for the sake of others. For the harm we have caused, known and unknown, forgive us. For the unjust demands we place on others and your creation, forgive us. For the ways we turn away from you and our neighbor, forgive us. Lead us back to you and set us on the right path. In the name of Jesus Christ, our Savior, amen. Beloved in Christ, God's justice stretches beyond all understanding. God's compassion is beyond compare. In Jesus, God is always making a new way for us. In Christ, you are already and always forgiven. Amen. We join in singing our entrance hymn, our opening hymn. You can find it printed in your bulletin, and the words will be on the screen as well. What can wash away my sin?
Thank you.
Our worship continues on page 78 in the green hymnal, or the words will be provided on the screen. The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all. In peace, let us pray to the Lord. For the peace from above and for our salvation, let us pray to the Lord. For the peace of the whole world, for the well-being of the Church of God, and for the unity of all, let us pray to the Lord. For this holy house, and for all who offer here their worship and praise, let us pray to the Lord. Help, save, comfort, and defend us, gracious Lord. This is the feast of victory for our God. Alleluia. Worthy is Christ. The Lord be with you. And we pray together the prayer of the day. Let us pray. Almighty God, whose people are knit together in one holy church, the body of Christ our Lord, grant us grace to follow your blessed saints in lives of faith and commitment, and to know the inexpressible joys you have prepared for those who love you. Through your Son, Jesus Christ our Lord, who lives and reigns with you in the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen. And you may be seated.
Good morning, everyone. First lesson today is Revelation 7, 13 through 17. After this I looked, and there was a great multitude that no one could count, from every nation, from all tribes and peoples and languages, standing before the throne and before the Lamb, robed in white with palm branches in their hands. They cried out in a loud voice, saying, "Salvation belongs to our God who is seated on the throne and to the Lamb." And all the angels stood around the throne and around the elders and the four living creatures. And they fell on their faces before the throne and worshiped God, singing, Amen. Blessing and glory and wisdom and thanksgiving and honor and power and might be to our God forever and ever. Amen. Then one of the elders addressed me, saying, Who are these, robed in white, and where have they come from? I said to him, Sir, you are the one that knows. Then he said to me, These are they who have come out of the great ordeal. They have washed their robes and made them white in the blood of the Lamb. For this reason, they are before the throne of God and worship him by day and night. Within his temple, and the one who is seated on the throne will shelter them. They will hunger no more and thirst no more. The sun will not strike them, nor any scorching heat. For the Lamb at the center of the throne will be their shepherd, and he will guide them to springs of water of life. And God will wipe away every tear from their eyes. The word of the Lord. Thanks be to God.
The children to come forward for children's message as we sing Jesus Loves Me. Jesus loves me, this I know, for the Bible tells me so. Little ones to him belong, they are weak, but he is strong. Yes, Jesus loves me. Yes, Jesus loves me. Yes, Jesus loves me. The Bible tells me so. Good morning.
Good morning.
Excellent. How's everybody today?
Good.
You are full of it. I'd love to hear that. Great. That's the question I'm going to ask you. What is in my hand?
A ring.
A ring.
And what is the shoes?
There we go. So, do you know what kind of ring this might be? Have you ever seen one like that? Your parents have one?
Yeah, it's a tiger.
So, no, it's not. Good point. It could be a wedding ring, but it's my class ring. So, this is a ring that I got when I graduated. And I went to Tri-Valley School. So, it says Tri-Valley High School, and it has a year on there.
What's the year?
1979. 1979, I'm proud of it, yes. All right, so do you know how I got this ring? What did I have to do? I had to graduate. And I had to go through first grade, second grade. I started in kindergarten. Are you in second grade now? Yep. I had to go through second grade. Who's your teacher? Yep, Miss Whipple. Mine was Mrs. Warren. I remember every one of my teachers. Teachers make a huge impression on you. But I went through all that, and then so I graduated. Do you think they gave me this ring? No, I had to still buy it. Then I had to go back and spend money to get it anyway. So exactly. It doesn't make sense, but they made me buy it because not everybody wanted one. So I wanted one. I got my name initialed in here. It doesn't fit anymore. But I had to do a lot of work to get it. That's what happens on Earth. We do a lot of work to get things we have. I have another ring. Is it the same ring? What is different about it?
It doesn't have a gem.
It doesn't have a gem on there. Very good. But I got both of them, yes.
It's not as rusty.
It what?
It's not as rusty.
It isn't as rusty. Good. So, which one do you think is older? It's actually this one. So this is my dad's class ring. And that was from 1950 from the Lyons School at that time. Do you know what I had to do to get this ring? Nothing. Nothing. And it was given to me after my dad passed away. So I inherited it. It was given to me. It is so much better to just get things given to you. But in this life, we have to work for things. There's a lot of things we have to do. But today we're going to hear about what it becomes to a saint. And it's not through something we do, but it's something that Jesus does for us. So let us pray. Heavenly Father, we thank you that you have come to us this day, reminding us that we have jobs to do in our community, to care for our neighbors, Give them what they need. But we also are here this day to hear what you have given to us, and that is eternal life by becoming saints who are forgiven. And all this we pray in Jesus' name, and all God's children said, amen. Amen. Thank you for coming up. And I invite the congregation to stand as we sing the gospel acclamation. Alleluia, Lord, to whom shall we go? You have the words of eternal life. Alleluia. Today's reading is not from one of the four Gospels, but it is good news from the book of Ephesians, the first chapter, and these are the words that Paul writes. In Christ, we have also obtained an inheritance, having been destined according to the purpose of him who accomplishes all things according to his counsel and will, so that we, who were the first to set our hope on Christ, might live for the praise of his glory. In him, you also, when you had heard the word of truth, the gospel of your salvation, and had believed in him and were marked with the seal of the promised Holy Spirit, this is the pledge of our inheritance toward redemption as God's own people, to the praise of his glory, the gospel of the Lord. And you may be seated. Dear saints of God, grace, mercy, and peace to you from God our Father and from his Son, Jesus Christ, who by whose blood you are now robed in white. Amen. This past September, the featured speaker at the South Dakota Synod Fall Theological Conference that I, among several other pastors, attended, encouraged us preachers not to be afraid to preach from the book of Revelation. And it's not something that we often do. We often, admittedly, avoid it, because there are some frightening images in the book of Revelation, and there are references to the events that will occur before Christ comes again that can leave believers confused and questioning. But this is not the intent of the vision that John received when he saw the vision in Revelation. It is to give faith that when Jesus comes again, you and I will be counted among the hosts in heaven. And on this All Saints Sunday, we get an encouraging description of what is in store for you and I from the vision that was revealed to John as he got a glimpse into heaven. The reading for today begins from Revelation, begins with the words, after this. Well, before this, someone had been very busy. Someone had just finished counting 144,000 people who are gathered around the throne of God. These 144,000 people were made up from 12,000 people from each of the 12 tribes of Jacob that had now entered into the kingdom of heaven. So John had just counted these 144,000 people, and he saw them over here, and it's as if he turned to the other side of heaven and turned his sights on an innumerable crowd, an even greater multitude of people that was so large they couldn't be counted. This innumerable crowd of people were not all from the Midwest of the United States. If you think that that's the only people that will be there, we're in for a surprise, I think, because they spoke different languages, they were of different colors, they were from every nation, and they came in all sizes and shapes. But they all had the same message. They cried out together in one voice and sang, "Salvation belongs to our God, who is seated on the throne, and to the Lamb." And they were all wearing white robes and had palm branches in their hands. And they were celebrating a victory of a battle that they did not fight, a victory that was won completely by the shedding of the blood of the Lamb, Jesus Christ. Then came the question by one of the elders that is often asked on All Saints Sunday. Who are these robed in white? And where did they come from? Other questions that might follow on this day might be, what makes somebody a saint? Or what makes a person holy is another way of saying it. And do you have to die first in order to become a saint? So it is good to be reminded of how one becomes a saint, because it is often confused by what we hear in the news today or the world around us. This past week, as I was listening to the news one morning, I heard a news anchor interview a person whose family member had died in the horrific recent shooting in Maine. This person who died perished while attempting to save many other people. This person who died was labeled as a hero. In another event that I noticed, this person that, and we heard this recently from just down at Renner, because there was two people that were going by the ball field at Renner and noticed someone laying out on the field. And these people took the initiative to stop and start administering CRP, and they saved the life of this man who was dying from having a heart attack. They too were called heroes. And make no mistake about it, what wonderful things these people did deserves to be told, and their efforts are completely commendable, and we need more caring people in this world. But what these people did not raise them to sainthood. Matthew, Mark, Luke, John, Paul did not receive the title of Saint Mark or Saint Luke because they authored books in the Bible. Stephen, as we've learned in the book of Acts, did not become a saint by losing his life for the sake of his faith when he was stoned to death. No one becomes holy by what they do here on earth. The large crowd of people that gathered around the throne of God were given white robes that we are told had been washed in the blood of the Lamb. As we often hear, Jesus works under the sign of opposites. What we expect him to do, he does something different. Because if you and I wanted to get a white garment to be sparkling clean, your best bet would be to try some Tide Ultra and probably spike in a half a cup of baking soda. No one would consider it logical to wash a garment that you wanted to become white as snow by washing it in blood. Anyone that does a little laundry knows that blood stains. Blood is not used to make something clean. But that is how all the saints' white robes became sparkling clean. They each had been washed in the blood of the Lamb. The stains that were on their garments were the sins that these saints had committed. But every one of these stains of sin were removed simply by hearing the words, "Your sins are forgiven." They became holy and saintly by hearing and believing that their sins were forgiven. The good news for each of us is that we do not have to wonder if we will be counted among the multitude of saints someday. The reading from Ephesians proclaims that in Christ we have also already obtained an inheritance. Our sainthood is in the present, not in the future. We do not have to die in order to receive our inheritance. It is yours today. Jesus is the one who had to die for us, and he has already done that for you. Jesus Christ's last will and testament has declared you as an inheritor of all the work that he has done for you. But of course, we're all inclined to want to provide some kind of proof that we deserve to receive Christ's inheritance. So if you were asked why you know that you will be counted among the saints on earth and in heaven, what would be your answer? Well, Paul has given us the words to say. We would say, as he told us, "I am a saint when I heard the word of truth, the gospel of your salvation, and had believed in him and were marked with the seal of the promised Holy Spirit." And when were you marked with the seal of the promised Holy Spirit? It was when you were claimed as a child of God in the waters of your baptism. So yes, today it is a great day to remember all the saints. We give thanks for the saints who gave their lives for the sake of the gospel. We give thanks as we remember all the saints who have received the seal of the promised Holy Spirit in baptism in our parish and throughout the world. And we remember the saints who have died in Christ from our parish and community this past year. And for many of us, we still mourn. But today, we also know that we will be comforted as we too have heard the gospel of the salvation that is ours. The salvation that is yours. Yours today. And for this we give thanks to Jesus Christ, who has robed you in his righteousness. Amen. And we prepare for our candle lighting service. Today we remember first those who have died in Christ, and we have had plenty of those from our congregation this past year. And so we are going to invite these families to come forward as I read their names first. And I will get a candle lighter for them. Let's see. Do we have another candle? Maybe, Rosalie, that lighter does not. Or we can just use this, I guess. We'll just use this. So at this time, I would invite, I don't know if there's anybody from the family of Sherry Folds here today. Probably not. So we will light a candle for Sherry Folds. And I'll invite all the family who would like to come forward as we light a candle for Tanya Vollen. Invite family for Jonathan Paulson to come forward. Those that would come forward as we remember Norman Nielsen. Invite the family of Ella Riswold to come forward. Thank you. I'm going to invite the family of Jean Hedlund to come forward at this time. Yes, blessed are those who mourn, for they will be comforted. We also remember those newly baptized into the faith, so I will light a candle for Lyric Thurburn. Then we'll invite the family for Rowdy to come forward too, and we'll have you be here as we light a candle for him. And now as we sing the hymn for all the saints, I'll invite each of you to come forward and remind, as you remember someone from your family or someone that you would like to be remembered, and I'll have you pick up the candle and we'll light it this time. You're welcome to come forward as we sing.
Thank you.
invite you to stand as you are able as we confess together our faith using the words of the Apostles' Creed. I believe in God the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth. I believe in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord. He was conceived by the power of the Holy Spirit and born of the Virgin Mary. He suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended into hell. On the third day he rose again. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen. Let us pray for the whole Church of God in Christ Jesus and for all people according to their needs. Heavenly Father, comfort us by your abiding presence and satisfy all who call on you in need. Especially this day, we pray for Harry Lowy, Dale Thompson, Gary Cosmic, Heather Peterson, Nathan Verkota, Kelly LaValier, Jimmy Vollen, Donna Lee Boyd, Betty Jean Benjamin, Rhoda Wold, Laura Lee Reynolds, Anita, Jay Vogt, Dennis Riswold, Caleb Jaton, Laurel Mader, Keith Fawcett, Carla Zoller, Valerie Voltz, Jan Davis, Carolyn Koopman, James Langloss, Matthias Warren, Carol, Billy, Nicole, Chad, Dane, Noah, Brian and Lisa, and the families of Norris Berg Jord, and also others whose names we now raise silently from our hearts. We pray that you would grant them patience in the midst of suffering and, according to your will, release them from their afflictions. Lord, in your mercy. O Lord, be with your church and all her members who belong to you by baptism and faith. At the bidding of the Lamb, our shepherd, give us ears to your word and faith to receive him in his blessed sacrament. Lord, in your mercy. Heavenly Father, grant that we may be brought to everlasting life with the faithful who have gone before us, who now rest from their labors. Lord, in your mercy. Almighty God, we give you thanks that you have washed us in the blood of the Lamb, written our names in the book of life, and made us a royal priesthood and heirs of an eternal inheritance. Though we are unworthy of your saving grace, we pray you would hear us in the name of Jesus Christ, in whom, with whom, and through whom all honor, glory is yours, Heavenly Father, with the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen. And the peace of the Lord be with you all. Let's share God's peace with one another. This time we will receive your offerings. I invite you to stand as you are able as we sing our offering hymn, "We Give Thee But Thine Own." And let us pray. Heavenly Father, we thank you for all the good gifts that you continue to give us without our asking. We pray that you would use these gifts that we have returned to you so that others may know the joy of your salvation and also be counted among the saints in glory. This we pray in the name of Jesus Christ, our Savior and Lord. Amen. The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is indeed right and salutary that we should at all times and in all places offer thanks and praise to you, O Lord, Holy Father, through Christ our Lord. In the blessedness of your saints, you have given us a glorious pledge of the hope of calling, that moved by their witness and supported by their fellowship, we may run with perseverance the race that is set before us, and with them receive the unfading crown of glory. And so with the church on earth and the hosts of heaven, we praise your name and join their unending hymn.
Power and might, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in. Hosanna in the highest.
In the night in which he was betrayed, our Lord Jesus Christ took bread. When he had given it, he broke it and blessed it, and gave it to all of his disciples, saying, "Take and eat. This is my body given for you. Do this in remembrance of me." And when supper had ended, he took the cup. And when he had given thanks, he gave it for all to drink, saying, "This cup is the New Testament in my blood, shed for you and for all people for the forgiveness of sins. Do this as often as you drink this in remembrance of me." Lord, remember us in your kingdom as you have taught us to pray. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. You may be seated. Communion today will be served around the altar, so you'll follow the directions of your ushers to come forward to receive this sacrament. All baptized Christians are welcome to come to the table to receive this sacrament. If you'd like to come forward and simply receive a blessing, I ask that you'd cross your arms in front of you, and I will give you that blessing. There are songs for us to sing during the distribution. Please sing. Come, for all is ready. invite you to stand as you are able as we pray. We give you thanks, Almighty God, that you have refreshed us through the healing power of this gift of life. And we pray that in your mercy you would strengthen us through this gift in faith toward you and in fervent love toward one another for the sake of Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Now receive the blessing. May the Lord bless you and keep you. May the Lord make his face shine on you and be gracious to you. The Lord look upon you with his favor and give you peace.
Amen. Amen. Amen.
You may be seated as we prepare to sing our final song or sending hymn. You'll see that as an insert in your bulletin. The notes of choir, notes of praise, choir will lead you. So can I borrow your sheet a minute? Since I lost mine. Okay. So, what? Yes, they are, but you'll follow here. So, you will notice on here there's a number one, and about midway down there's a number two. The women will be number one, and the west side will be number one. This will be the two side, and you'll be following the men. You're still with us? Okay, good. So, as we sing this hymn, we'll sing it through completely once. You go through part one and part two. Then when we come back and start singing it again, the women will start on part one, and then we'll stay silent until they get to part two. Then we'll
start singing part one,
and we'll sing together. Melanie, are you going to come up and sing with us? You can do it. You can sing there. That's fine. All right. All right. So, yeah, we're not, yeah, don't be scared, we're not singing in Swedish. So, yeah, all right.
Go now in peace and serve your neighbor.